What's going on, guys? My name is Dust. I'm going to be showing you the current, or at least the way that I run the current any percent yes route. Yes, meaning that Voidwalker's arsenal, or the DLC, is included in the run. That gives you a few little bone charms and some money in the early game to start you off with. So, I've been streaming this game a lot recently, and a lot of my viewers have been asking me for a tutorial on this because they can't find an updated route on this. That's why I'm going to be showing you this. This is going to be kind of-ish noob-friendly, but for the most part, I'll show you guys, like, the easy way to do things, and then I'll show you, like, the more advanced slash way that you're supposed to do things. So, let's just get into this. Right from the start, one thing I want to mention is the game is played on easy, and when you hit start and you hit new game, you'll start, like, out here in the water, and you'll drive up off this boat into the water here. The way that this run works is the community has agreed that the run starts once you gain control of Corvo, so you can make a quick save here and then just quick load and then start right off the bat, right? So from right here, what you want to do is you want to get to this flag, you want to jump over it, and then jump over this fence. The way however you do that is up to you. There's not too many different ways that you can do it, but that's one way. Other ways, you want to vault over here, use your momentum to turn and go here, but that's besides the point. That's more advanced. So right here, you have a choice between two elevators, because you want to skip a cutscene right here with Emily. So you can avoid this cutscene by doing the elevator glitch. You can do this by doing one of the two. This is the easier one. How to do the elevator is you want to go into the wall, turn slightly into it, hold back and into the wall, and then jump as you get to the end. And it should boost you all the way up, like that. Oops. Like this. Now this side in particular is the easier side, but it is also slower. But it's easier, so I would recommend this if you're new to the game. So you want to jump up across the walls right here. So this is the wall that you get onto when you do the elevator. You want to jump here, and make sure you're on the lower half of this arch, otherwise you're going to die to fall damage. But you're going to run off and then jump onto this railing. The reason I died is because I fell off a lot of times, so I'm already at low HP. So I'm at full HP now. I'm here. Jump here. Jump here. And then make sure that you avoid this invisible wall here. It starts at this flower pot. Oops. It starts at the flower pots on both sides and goes across this metal fence. So that's one way to do it. And then the other way is this elevator. This one's a little more tight. But you're going to jump basically and climb this wall right here. You should go into it. So if you do it too early like I did just there, you're going to hit this lamp. So that's going to lose you time. Like that. But the other way to do it is like this. It's very common for you to go only halfway up the elevator and then for it to stop. That's very common. All you do is the same thing you did the first time. Back up into the wall and then hold spacebar. This one's a little bit more finicky and a little bit more troublesome, so this might take you a few tries in a run, but the nice thing about it is that it's right at the beginning, so it's only like an 8-second investment. No, it's literally a 4-second investment, and if you don't get it, then you just reset, so it's not that big a deal. But once you hit this elevator, you go up again. The way that I do this is I sprint and I vault onto the other side and then fall off. I fell into the cutscene because I stopped sprinting and I lost my momentum. Whoops. That's a god elevator. That doesn't happen very often. It's just like a one-shot all the way up. But like I was showing you before, like this. You fall here and then you run across. The other way you can do this is once you hit the elevator on this side, you jump, land here, and then go onto the other side. Either way is fine. Jump up, continue running. Don't jump off of it because it's slower to jump and move. So you want to just sprint and fall off of it. Once you get here, there's a little dialogue thing right here, and you skip through it. But you can actually save yourself some time by, at the top of the steps, jumping and then holding E to skip it. That way you're still doing the dialogue skip, but you're a few feet like in front of where you're supposed to be, and then run forward and talk, and then enter this little cutscene right here. They're my citizens, and we'll save them from the plague if we can. All of them.
Very well.
We will not speak of this again.
Mother, Corvo's back.
Mother, Corvo is back.
Thank you, Emily.
Leave us, please.
Leave us, please.
As you wish, Your Majesty.
Corvo, 2 days early. Full of surprises, as usual.
Corvo, 2 days early. Full of surprises.
So after running this game a bunch, you'll hit the intro a lot, so you start to memorize all the dialogue. But once you gain control, sprint up to the Empress,
fair wind that brings you home to me.
Cue her dialogue, and then give her this note immediately. Excuse me. From here, you're going to do another elevator. You're going to sprint over across this table, and this first plant right here, there's an invisible wall going all the way up. You're going to go into it, look to the left a little bit, and do the same thing that you did with the other ones. This one's really, really weird, so make sure that you hold space bar until you're all the way up, and then once you are up, hit space again just to be sure. But this next part is all timing. The way that I set this up is right between this little berry bush and this little non-berry bush, I set my crosshair, and on top of the fence, I look straight ahead. Two assassins are going to spawn here. This right one is the one I'm looking at. The second he blinks for the first time, right there, I think I'm a little early, but that's the timing cue that I'm going off of. The second that he goes into his blink the first time is when I'm doing this. So they both appear. First one blinks, second one blinks, and then I start sprinting forward. What that does is it allows you to skip the tutorial scene, which takes like maybe 9 or 10 seconds, where the three assassins spawn on the ground and you have to kill all of them. By killing yourself with the fall damage right as it starts, for whatever reason, there's like a failsafe, and it just skips you through it. I won't question why, it just happens, but yeah. Some things to keep in mind that I didn't mention in the very beginning of the run that I probably should have. The run is... this game, for this route, is run on patch 1.2.
Protect her.
If you do not know how to do that, I will link a video showing you how to do all of that stuff by DrTChops. He runs this game as well. I believe he's currently, at the time of this video, third place on the leaderboards. He has held a world record a couple times, but like the top three guys, Heny, Mr. Walrus, and T-Chops, keep trading it off. But I'll leave a video in the description below to show you how to configure all your settings correctly and stuff for the run. But make sure before this cutscene ends, before this guard hits you in the face, hold your action key. Mine is E. I think it's default bound to F. What that's going to do is we're going to skip a dialogue by storing the input from the previous segment. So that is called RE Stored Skip, aka S. So once this starts, look to the bottom left and you'll see the little skip for dialogue thing, and it'll disappear immediately. Like that. Essentially, we're just storing the input of holding E from a previous part of the game and then saving it until that.
You should eat, Corvo.
So this is the start of the prison split. What you want to do here is you want to run forward, grab this bread immediately, and then read the note and exit it as quick as possible, and then grab the key. Like that, and then open the door. What you want to do here, you're going to run up to this door right here, and you're going to jump onto it, and then slide all the way to the left. The little, for whatever reason, this door is really difficult sometimes to get on top of, but we want to get up here, move to the left, and you're going to slide up, you're going to elevate yourself up this little sign right here. So once you're looking straight ahead, turn left so that you're inward, and then do the same elevator stuff. Jump here just to be safe. You're going to run across here, and you're going to do the elevator again. Right here. Sometimes it's... this one is a super, super finicky. I keep saying that for all of them, but essentially elevators are just really finicky in this game. So once you do that, you're going to run across... oops. My mistake. I just, like, completely just ran off. So you're going to jump here, slide over, do the elevator, do it again. And then make sure that you walk across this little... there's like a wall right here. Make sure you walk across that because there's a hitbox that you can walk across. And then walk on this side of it. If you walk inward, you can actually fall through. See how like it's like falling through? There's like little spaces in between. And you don't want to do that. So you want to walk across this as close as possible. Once you get to the end, you're going to jump onto this little part. And then jump again before the end. And crouch before you hit the water. Crouching before you hit the water decreases the distance that you'll fall into it. Vault over that little cart right there, and then vault again here, and then get to this door. Once you're in here, you're gonna walk and sprint forward immediately. You're gonna do a double vault here. Vault over the first time, take a short, like, less than a second pause. That way you set yourself up correctly and do it again. And then spam jump inputs. If you have your scroll wheel down set to jump, you can do that. Otherwise, just spam your spacebar key and then come through here. My game closed. That was weird. My game didn't crash, but it did close. I don't know what that was. The video's still going, so we're fine. So continue sprinting forward. That was really weird, guys. I have no idea what happened. And you're gonna sprint and jump into the water. You wanna get as far as you can, make sure you crouch again. And then here, you're gonna aim for this bottle. If you don't get it, it's not the worst. Once you come out of the water, you're gonna aim down to the left, pick up the bottle if you can get it, and if not, whatever. Throw it at the body, otherwise pick him up or slide into him to knock him off. And then hold E on the wheel. Position yourself as far away as you can, that way you spend less time traveling. Jump here at the top of that little bump right there, get a vault. Jump onto this cart, jump onto this rock, and jump onto these rocks. And then hold E on this. Jump through the middle here. And then you're gonna do another elevator here along this beam. So come through the wall right here, back up into the thing, and then jump. Jump there, and you wanna, the way you jump here is, you wanna sprint, jump onto this little tin can right here, and then jump again and vault onto the railing. It's not that you can, we're not doing it so that you can avoid this damage. You're doing it because it's giving you a movement speed boost, right? Look. Like that. Sprint up here, read the note, and then once it opens, you want to jump onto the box as soon as you can. And you want to be on the box because the camera's going to fade from black to the gameplay. But while it's fading, you can actually move your character. So during the screen, you want to open the door and then go through it. So what I did right here is, this is called swordless. Essentially, we're sheathing our weapon and keeping our offhand weapon out at the same time. The reason that you want to do this is because when you're running with your sword out, you move 30% slower, I believe. And when you have it away, you can move at full movement speed. Like this. See how it's like slower than this? The cool thing is if you sheath your weapon and then use your offhand ability, so right click, it'll keep your offhand ability out and you're still moving as if you didn't have anything out. So this is what you want to do ideally for like the entire run. But then you run through this wooden beam right here, and then you jump here. Ideally, you want to vault over in one go. But if that doesn't happen, then that's fine too. You don't want this though. That's really bad. So you just like sprint and then jump over here. Jump through this little hole right here. Walk forward and jump on that guard's head. Walk across this little rockway, I guess. Jump there. This guard shouldn't be here, but because their positioning is messed up because I took very long to do things. Where are my autosaves? So just from here, you run up, hit the elevator, jump here, vault over, read the note, jump onto the box, grab your weapons, and then make sure you open the door during the dark. That'll save you the most time. If you can't, it's not the worst thing in the world, especially if you're just starting out. Go into swordless. You want to jump here. Jump here, hit the... oops, that was awkward. Hit the guard. That way you don't like die to the fall damage or whatever. Jump across this. And this guard will be here. Ideally, you want him to damage boost you, but if he's in your way, just shoot him and get him out of your way. And then... Oh yeah, real quick, I didn't really talk about this jump. So, the way that this jump works is, if you want to be safe about it, you can just jump here and then walk across. Otherwise, aim for like the top of this little brown part of the pipe, and you jump onto it, and you can go like that. It's a little bit faster, so that's what you want, but if you can't do it, just do it the safe way. As you're running here, you want to shoot your crossbow, and you're going to be doing it as you're running, so your aim isn't the greatest. But you want to aim for this. Hitting this is going to drop this, and it's going to explode. So the reason why that would be beneficial for us... Oops, it didn't take my autosave. The reason that you would want that is because if you're running past it and you shoot it at the same time, when it drops, it'll explode behind you, so it'll boost you forward. Right? So hit this. And I might not get it here, but whatever. Like that. Lovely. So that's gonna give you like a small amount of boost. So you wanna aim for that. If you can't get it, it's not the worst though.
I'm Samuel.
Run over, talk to Samuel. And then this is the end of the prison. Or end of sewers, I should say.
I can still hardly believe it. I'll take you to meet them. Just down the river from here.
Hit enter on the first option once it comes up. And then you go into this little end screen. Make sure you hit enter as fast as you can, because you do, the timer still runs during those screens. So if you're slow about it, you'll lose time for free. But other things I want to mention real quickly. Like I said before, any resources that, like any downloads you need or videos, links to configurations that you need, I will put in the description of this video. I will also leave a link to the speedrunning forums for this game. That way, if you have any questions, they might be already answered on there. I will also leave a download link to LiveSplit, which is the program that I use to record the time. There's an auto splitter function on that too, so it's really good for this game, and that's ideally what you want to run with. Back to this. Once you come out of the boat, if you hold forward and sprint, you sometimes get stuck on Samuel's body or on the boat. So the safest way to do this is hold W and A when you're coming off the boat, along with your sprint, until you get over this little lip. And once you do that, you can let go of A and just hold forward, like that. I'm gonna sprint up here, up the steps, go through this door, and you're gonna go for the money on the right side. It's pretty fast because there's a cutscene. There's coin right there, and I missed it, but there's another. So there's a coin right here you want to get, and then there's this you want to get. You want to get all of that because you're going to use the money to buy potions, a grenade, and a rune. And if you're short on the money, you're going to be unhappy with the run. Also, need to do the autosave before. And the reason why you want to do this on the first shot and you don't want to go back is, one, it's shorter to do it on the first shot, and second, you're gonna lose your dialogues. I'm a noob. I don't know why I can't do this like when I'm practicing or doing this off stream. I do it on stream all the time. So grab this coin and grab. Oh my god. So you're gonna do the dialogue, and then as it's fading out, you wanna hold E again. This time I'm just gonna show you what the dialogue thing looks like. So if you just run forward, hold E to skip the dialogue, and then press it again immediately after, and that's going to do another storage skip like we did in the beginning of the game, except this is like without a cutscene in between. And then it just skips the dialogue. So just so that we have the money this time. Go through. I don't know why I can't grab the money this right now, guys. This is ridiculous. Grab the money. Grab the other money. Uh-huh. There we go. And then hold E again after the dialogue. Run into Piero. We'll skip his. Grab this right here on the bottom shelf. Stand about here and grab this oil tank without having to run up. And put it into the machine. Hold E to skip, or F, whatever your action key is. Press down and enter immediately once you get the choice, because you don't want to look at his inventory yet. And then you're going to hit enter again on his next dialogue. And right after you hit enter, hit your action key, or E, F, whatever it is, again, and we're going to do another dialogue skip. Also, this is the outsider skip. Assuming that you rebound your scroll wheel down to jump, right when it shows you that crosshair at the end as you're fading out right there, if you put a jump input, you'll go through the ceiling like this, and you'll warp up, saving you about like 10 seconds. Still holding E, and then hopefully you skip the dialogue. If not, it's whatever. But now you have blink. This is where the run gets fun. I'm just going to do this once, just to show you what it looks like, and then I'll, like, go over it a little bit slower afterward. Whoops. You don't want a hard fall there, but you grab the rune, and that's, like, the end of that. Real quickly, this is what you want to go for. So right when you start off, you want to blink here once, grab this potion as you're running. You want to do it as you're running, that way it's faster. But if you can't, then it's not like the worst, and you can like, you can pause and grab it. It's really not that big a deal. But ideally you want to sprint, open the chest and grab the potion at the same time. Blink there, blink here. You'll have one more blink, so you blink and then use your mana potion in the air. Grab this potion, blink forward. And as you're falling, you want to blink so that you land on this guy right here. You want to land on the guy, so however you do it is up to you, but this is the timing that I do for it. There's a bunch of different ways you can do it, but the way I do it is I blink once here, and right when I fall off the ledge, I blink again, jump, and then blink. Use a potion, go forward a little bit, and then blink so that you slide off of this, otherwise you'll get like a hard fall. And then right here, it's pretty tricky, but you want to aim it so that your arrow is here. That way you get this auto get up. And then after you blink through, you want to continue holding forward, open the chest, and grab this potion before the cutscene enters, because once the cutscene enters, it's gonna displace your body to the left, and it'll lock your camera for a short time. So I'll show you that again, what I mean by camera locking. So I'll make a quick save right here. So if I do this, I missed the potion. I'm going to try to move right. My camera's like locked. And now I can move it. And since it displaces you, it's going to be really slow. So you want to grab the potion before the cutscene starts. That way you can just start going forward. Switch to blink. Blink once there. Blink another time there. Blink, fall here. Use a potion. Jump and blink. Blink here. Blink here. Blink here. And grab this and grab the rune. So as this menu's coming up, it's going to be like the upgrade skill menu. Do not hit enter. Hit escape to close the menu, because if you take the dark vision, you're gonna just screw up the entire run for you. You have to reset, because now you can't get agility. But the second that you hit enter, you can hold E and skip the dialogue pretty quickly. Now you're waking up in your room and you want to exit the level. So here is where the Voidwalker's arsenal stuff is. You want to walk forward, grab this rune specifically called Void Channel. What that's gonna do is the description is undefined for whatever reason, but I don't know why it's undefined, but what it does is it improves all of your abilities, right? So if you were to get all of your powers, if you have this bone charm equipped, it'll slightly increase the potency of each one of them. But basically what it means for us is our blinks will be slightly longer each time. So you want to grab this rune, grab this pouch and this pouch, and that's gonna give you 1500 coins. If you grab anything extra, it's fine, you don't have to worry about it, right? But make sure that you grab the Void Channel first. Now it shows. Because the list will show. I think it's in order of when you grab them. It's not alphabetical. So if you grab Void Channel first, it'll always be the bottom one. So you want to make sure you do that. So once more, as if we're waking up, walk forward, grab the charm and the money. Come through the window here. Land on this. Make sure you grab this for the last 20 coins that you need and talk to Piero. Hit enter. Grab the rune, one grenade, and 10 potions. Once you're here, switch to blink. Fall and blink toward the door. Open your powers menu. Upgrade agility. And upgrade or select on Void Channel. Go into swordless. Talk to Havelock. Go swordless again. And you want to blink here onto this table. And then double jump and blink to Samuel. The reason why we want to do that and not the other way is because there's a cutscene with Callista right here. So if you walk forward, it'll automatically select it. And if you don't like go through the table, like if you blink here, you'll get it. So you want to make sure that you blink either into the table or on top of it. But essentially you just want to be like in this area. You want to like avoid that cutscene.
Ready to go. Just give the signal.
And then talk to Samuel, and then we're ready to go. One thing to keep in mind, by the way, I have a lot of the default keybinds changed that a lot of the other runners don't change. So keep in mind that whatever keybinds work for you, make sure that you change them. Because you don't want to, like, change your... But, like, make sure that, like, your keybinds are efficient. You don't want to make your keybinds all weird and wonky. get used to it, and now you're like stuck with that muscle memory, and, it's like really hard for you to change, because it'll take you like maybe like an entire day to like really get used to like new keybinds. So make sure that whatever keybinds you set in the beginning, that they're efficient, okay? So right here, this is the start of the Campbell split. Once we get off the boat, we're gonna go into swordless immediately. We're gonna double jump and then blink onto that pipe right there, the really big one. Excuse me. Swordless, sprint off the boat, double jump here, blink to the top of this, double jump over the fence, blink, use your potion because you can't pick up more than 10, blink here, double blink here, whoops, let me show that again. You know what, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to just quickly run through the entire level. Yeah, I'm going to run through the entire level and then I'll go over it like slowly. Okay, I think that'll make it easier. Oops. Special announcement from our honorable Lord Regent. This is the Lord Regent speaking. What the fuck is with regret that I announced in my term?
Are you the second day's meeting? I was just reading in the archive about the heresy.
Whoops. Whoops. Ideally, you want to one-shot those, but I'm a scrub. Okay, so that's the level. Going through it again slowly this time. That way I can explain to you guys what's going on. But for those of you who already know how the game works, the mechanics, that's how you do the run. But now I'll go into more detail for those that don't know.
It'd be a rough trip. Used to be to go straight up Clavering Boulevard, but now it's not so easy.
So the way that this double blink is gonna, or this double jump blink that's gonna work, when you double jump in the game and you blink, the mechanics are really cool, because what I'm doing is right at the start of my second jump, I'm blinking, but because I'm doing it at the start of my jump, I don't lose that momentum I was going to gain from my jump, so I continue upward through the air that I would have gotten after I blink as well. So think of it as like, instead of jumping twice and then blinking, I'm jumping, blinking, and then jumping again, theoretically, right? So for example, here, I'm going to double jump, and at the top of my jump, I'm gonna blink. Same thing for here. Same thing. Or I'm going to blink once there. And you're going to use your potion because you can't grab more than 10. Otherwise, you'll get stuck trying to pick up this potion, and you can't pick it up. Right? So once you're here, double jump here, and then you're going to sprint forward. And at the top of your first blink, at the very start of it, you're going to blink. And then you're going to blink again. That way, you have time when you're in the air to do a second blink. And you're... gonna get a damage cancel on top of the train. I know that this is like a lot of terminology that you may not understand, but you get used to it. Like this, and then blink again. Blink down here, take your potion. For the easy route, just grab the whale oil tank and pull it out. Blink here, grab that potion and grab this rune through the windows, and then blink through this door. I need to set up a quick save. I'll show the more like advanced way that I did when I first showed off the level. So once you're here, right? I'll make a quick save here. So blink down here, and the easier way is to take the whale oil tank out. Blink here, and then grab the potion and the rune. Right? You grab the note. It's not the worst thing in the world. Just make sure that you pick up the rune as well. The more advanced way to do it is jump here, and then you can actually blink past it. It's a little finicky, like everything in this game is. So make sure that when you do it, you're not in the center, because it's really hard to do. You want to align yourself to the right side of the wall, or the right side of the fence. Make sure that you can see your blink marker past it, and then it'll work. Whoops. So for example, like, check out my blink icon and see how it's past the fence the entire time. That means I won't die to it. So double jump, or jump twice and grab those two. the potion and the rune through the windows. Once you hear, you want to blink twice on the ground, use a potion, and then double jump, and then jump onto this little thing right here. Double jump again, and then jump onto this ledge. Double jump, and then blink in the air, land there, and then blink again. Double jump here and do the same thing. Blink here, and then blink through the window. Grab this potion, and then now we're going to go into a slip clip. So slip clipping is a exploit in the game using the lean functions and sprinting into a wall. So for thinner walls, if you lean and then sprint into them, your head will poke through, right? So by doing this, if you hold our blink, see how like if I go through the wall and then I turn my mouse toward it, you can see the blink icon? That means that we can blink through the wall, which is pretty cool, right? So this is why we call it slip clipping, because you're slipping through the wall by clipping through it. And then you're going to let go of your blink, hit this guy, and make sure that when you do it, you jump into him. Otherwise, you'll get, like, really slow animations. Oops. Like, for example, if you just go up to him and kill him, you get, like, really slow kill animations, which you do not want. So make sure that you get this jumping animation cancel by jumping through him. If you jump too far away, you'll do that. You want to jump and get this little slash right there. You won't get it a lot at first, but play around with it, get used to it. And make sure you grab this. If you don't take the blackmail journal, you can't finish the level, so make sure that you grab that. Slip clip through again, grab that rune on the door, and then slip clip through this window. Make sure you use a health potion, because when you drop through to touch this door on the other side, when you land here into the next level, you're going to take a lot of damage. And if you're not full HP, it's very likely that you can die. Blink once there, jump onto this building, blink again, use your potion, blink down here. And then line your crosshair up with this little boat. It's moving at the moment, but if you're doing it fast, it should be like around here. You know, sprint forward, blink, crouch in the air, pull out your crossbow, shoot, and then land on Samuel's head. The way this game works is when you fall onto people, you actually deal damage to them, right? So the higher you are and the longer you're falling, the faster you're going, etc., the more damage you will deal to them. So, because Samuel is a friendly NPC, you do not want to hurt him lethally, otherwise you'll have to restart the level. So the way we like get around this is we lessen our fall damage. Whoops, not by doing that. We lessen our fall damage by crouching midair and shooting our crossbow, and it decreases our falling velocity. And then make sure you talk to Samuel immediately. And then that's the end of the level.
Campbell lived a pretty posh life.
It's really unfortunate when you have a really good intro prison sewers and then going into Campbell is going to be great, and then you deal too much damage with Samuel, you have to reload, and then like the run is like screwed, right? Hit enter, yes, take me back, and then it's going to fade out, and that's the end of the Campbell split. Again, make sure you hit enter through the screen as fast as possible, that way you don't lose that much time, and then continue. So we're going to do another dialogue skip here. Make sure you hold E, and right now, your crossbow might still be out if you didn't switch back to your blink, so keep that in mind. What you want to do is switch to blink if you don't already have it. As soon as you're out of this little scene right here, that when you gain control, make sure you switch to blink, and you hold forward. Blink here, and blink here, still holding E, then you skip with the dialogue right there, and you go into the next level. So now, this is the beginning of the Weeper's level. You're gonna wake up in your bed again, and immediately we're gonna just jump right into this. So pull out your sword, go into swordless, come outside this doorway. You want to be like kind of outside of it, but against this wall. Aim your blink outside the window and a little bit higher than mid-level, and then hold forward, and that way you'll get a damage cancel on this little metal thing right here. Just quickly going over the different types of jumps in the game. If you jump and fall, there's an animation like this called a hard fall. And there's one variation where you don't get any, you don't take damage, but you do lose time because it does that animation. And there's another hard fall where it's extremely high, you fall and you take fall damage. I mean to auto load. If you do, there's a sweet spot in the middle between the two heights. And we call that a damage cancel. Right? So by doing this, you fall, you take the damage, very small amount, but you don't get an animation. So once you do that, turn around, go through this door, sprint, and then slide through, and then uncrouch yourself to fall through without hitting the chain. And then here, how you're supposed to get through this door, you're supposed to have a key. But the game is, like, really weird, and the key is on the other side of this door, so you're supposed to go through around the other way. But if you crouch in front of the door, lean to the left, and then aim around this corner, you can actually grab the key through the door and then open it up, right? So then you're going to blink here, pull out your sword, blink here, and then kill this guy with one hit, and let's start hurt. The way that killing in this game works, by the way, you need to hit your enemy with that slash before they see you. If they are aware of your presence, you won't kill them in one hit. So you absolutely need to make sure that you space it correctly, otherwise you're gonna lose time. So you start here, blink out the window. I think I'm too low. No, I actually got it. Sprint out here, slide, uncrouch, crouch here, lean, blink here. Oops, I'm stuck. Pull out your sword, blink, and then slash them right here, and then sleep dart the other one. Otherwise, you're gonna lose time for taking too long. I don't know why autosaves are so, like, all over the place. So I will show you how, like, you can not one-shot them. Whoops. Make a quick save here. So, see how he's aware of me, right? Look, he's aware of me. Now I do it a shot, but he's still alive, so you can't one-shot him. So you want to make sure that you slash them before they're aware of your presence. That way you get the insta-kill. Pull out your sleep dart, slash her, switch back to blink, go into swordless, grab the rune in there, grab the rune of the water here, blink out the water, take agility, and then sprint over here. Blink there once, open this, double jump. Talk to Admiral Havelock, skip his dialogue, pull out your sword, blink past the bar. I did it slowly because I was trying to, like, show you, like, where to blink. But you shouldn't blink into Havelock, otherwise you're going to lose time, obviously. So right here, there's over here, boom, boom, grab this rune, grab this rune, and I think I missed that jump up, but you want to jump onto this part, or as close as you can to, like, the middle of this. I don't know what's got me stuck. That was interesting. I was completely stuck. There was, like, an invisible wall or something. But yeah, make sure that you jump as close as you can to the little hallway. That way, you save as much time as possible. The less distance you have to travel, the more time you'll save. So like this. Skip his dialogue, and then quickly blink past him. Come over here. Double jump here and blink into Samuel. You want to wait to make sure that you have two blinks going into the golden cat split. Otherwise, you're going to get a little bit messed up. So this is the same beginning as the Campbell split. This is just like a different pathing for it, though. There is a bit of RNG in this. I will show you how to complete both routes, but I can't guarantee that we'll get bad RNG both, or we'll get both RNGs, or both combinations, right? That's what I meant to say. There's two different variations of the RNG. One is good, one is bad. If he don't kill you, this here's his territory. So you should have two blinks going into this before your mana bar is going to be empty. So you blink twice and then you refill with your potion.
I'll lay low, but keep an eye out for you and the little lady you bring him back. Good luck to you. I know Emily.
So as soon as you gain control, you got your sword, go swordless. Blink up here, blink up here, use your potion. Blink here, grab the potion here, double jump here, and then blink once this time. Aim about there and then fall. You shouldn't get a hard fall if you're good. I suck though. This time, you can't blink past the fence, because for whatever reason the hitbox is different now, and you're very likely to kill yourself if you try it again.
Be careful going up the street.
So here, here, here. There we go. Whoops. It's awkward. You should only have one or zero blinks going to this. Usually I have zero, so whatever. But blink there, jump over here, grab this rune on the little thing right there, jump here, and then jump here, and make sure that your blink is, like, on the platform, that when you open the window, you don't get, like, elevated off of it. Open this door, talk to Emily, skip her dialogue, back up a little bit, and aim out the window. You want to drop here, damage cancel onto the balcony, and grab this key. Go through this door, grab this rune, and as soon as you open this door, I actually opened up my menu before I opened it, but as soon as you open the door, open the menu and take blink 2. So, there's two lights right here, and if they're not lit up, that means you have bad RNG. So by doing this, you go, one Pendleton is up in this middle top room, you kill him, grab these two potions, and then jump here. Damage cancel onto the ground right here, slip clip through the wall, pull out your grenade, and aim right about here. Like, you want to stand in the middle above this thing, right above the pipe, or right above the black wall, and right to the left of the pipe, you want to throw your grenade. That's going to drop the grenade into the room, and it's going to kill the Pendleton twin. Pull out your blink, and jump onto this invisible like stairwell right here, and then blink across over here, back into bounds. If you blink too low, or you miss the jump completely, you're going to fall out of bounds and die, so make sure that you space that correctly, and then blink out here. So, if you notice that Emily's facing us right now, and the mission continued immediately, if you're really fast with this, it'll actually glitch her out, and she'll be turned the other way, and you won't be able to progress. So how you fix this is, once you're out here, grab this key, and it's still going to be bad RNG, because the RNG begins when you first load up this section of the level. So do this. Slip up here, fire a grenade, throw it here, go back into bounds. Sometimes you get stuck like that, but if you just spam spacebar, usually it'll fix itself. But she's turned around. The way to fix her is you sprint into her and she'll turn around for you. And then don't go through the door until the arrow shows up for the next objective, otherwise you'll softlock yourself and you won't be able to progress without going back through. Jump here after you grab that potion, use mana potion here, jump there, jump here, blink there. You want to fall here, and you want to make sure you have two blinks before you do this, because you don't want to use another potion. So double jump here, and then blink there. And that's the end of the level. I guess I'll try to go through it more slowly this time. Wait, where is that safe? Oh, no. This is the wrong mission. Do this. This time I'll go into it more slowly. I'll show you where you're supposed to place your blinks and stuff like that. That way you guys can practice it better. And then I will also show you the placements for good RNG if we don't have good RNG here. I'll show you where they're supposed to be, and I'll show you how to deal with them if they are. I don't remember if I'd already talked about this, but there is a button. I think it's default to the alt key. It might not be, but that's what mine's set to. It's the guard button for the blade. I'll show you guys that real quick. The cool thing about this feature is that even though it's meant to be for guard, we actually use it a lot in the run, almost always. And the way that we use this is, instead of using it to block, if your weapon is sheathed, you can do it to instantly pull out your knife. I don't know if you've noticed that I've been doing that. Otherwise, you have to pull it out this way, and you have to, like, wait a second before you can actually use it. So, for example, when we gain control right here, I go pull out my sword, and then go sword this immediately. Jump there, then jump here, and grab this potion. Make sure that you get on top of this wall, and then right here, you're going to jump forward, and aim, like, right above this lamp, and then blink after you jump once. Blink again here. You should have to use your potion, so you blink here, grab this, blink over this, and then blink into the door. Right as you come out of here, you blink once, and then you use a potion if you don't have a second blink. Double jump, and then grab this rune. Jump out the window, onto this, and jump here. So you do this one of two ways. One way that people do this is they blink right here, and open it like that, and go through. The way that I do it is everything seems to flow really nice for me, so what I do is, once I'm here, I thought I saved closer, so I apologize for that, but, whoops. That's how I blinked before I jumped, right as I jumped, so it kind of messed up. I'm going to make a quick save right here, just so I can attempt to get both RNGs. I don't know why my quick save isn't working, but whatever. So you blink here, use a potion, blink here. Double jump there, take that, and then go through the window. The way that I do it is once I land here, I double jump immediately again, and then blink, and go through the window, open the door. So here, again, fall back a little bit, blink outside. Sometimes you land on the guard, but you, realistically you want the damage cancel. Come through here, grab the rune, and this time we have good RNG. If those lights are lit up, that means you have good RNG, and this is their placements. So one's going to be in the top left room, so you blink here, jump over this archway, pull out the grenade that you bought, and throw it at the top, right above there, and that'll kill the Pendleton. Then jump out, pull out your sword again, and kill this Pendleton, blink here, and sometimes the guards will be in your way there, but blink there. Jump over the thing, and then look, Emily's there. Also, we just saw her, I'm pretty sure, up there, which is pretty funny. And when you come out here, you want to grab the potion, and you want to vault over this little wooden plank. It's kind of weird to do, but you want it like that, ideally. You blink once here, use your potion, blink on top of this pipe, and then run and blink. Make sure you don't hit the lamp because it's going to be in your way, so you have to be patient, and then land on these boxes, sprint, and then jump onto this back onto this railing. Make sure you sprint off of here because you should only have... So for how the mana usage should be at this part is it should be... I'll just show you. So blink out here. Ideally, you want the damage cancel not to hit the guard. Whoops. No. Yes. So once you're out here, pay attention to the mana that I have, right? So unstuck Emily, open the door, and you'll have one blink coming out here. So pay attention to my bar right now. See how it's like, I have two blinks left, but it has to recharge a little bit? You want to wait for it to recharge. Blink onto this bar. I hit the guard, but you should land on top of there, and then blink again onto Samuel. You don't want to use a potion there, otherwise you'll be missing one later on in the route. But then that's how you do the split. Hit enter to yes to go back. Hit enter again to skip this screen as soon as possible, and then you'll continue. So this next split is the bridge split. And I don't know what I want to comment about it. We'll get to it when we get there. I'll talk about it when we get there.
Talking about?
Oh, my grown-up business, girl. I mean, your ladyship. Forgive me.
It's okay. I heard a lot of grown-up business at the Golden Cat.
Also, this dialogue right here is like... On piloting this boat. The game needs to chill. Like, this dialogue is terrible right now. Cliff is gonna ask Emily if she would like to see the room in the tower. And then Emily asks, or follows up with, can I see it? Like, I don't understand, man. I don't understand how that made it through.
Young Lady Emily, I'm Callista. I'll be caring for you and schooling you while you're with us.
Pleased to meet you.
As am I. Would you like to see your room in the tower?
Can I see it?
Yes.
No. I changed my mind. You know how I offered to show you your room in the tower, and then you asked me if you could see it?
Good.
I changed my mind at that time.
I
don't want you to see it.
I'm
not going to show it to you, alright?
I'll see you later.
What the hell is that dialogue? So, after they leave, you talk to Havelock, and right after you are finished talking with him, you're going to go left and talk to Pendleton.
And with the Pendleton twins gone, our own Lord Pendleton will assume their votes in Parliament.
Boom, 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 boom. So to do this, you want to pull out your blink really quickly, and then sprint to the left, and then double jump over to Pendleton, and then blink.
Lord Pendleton requests your attention.
Right here. Talk to him, skip his dialogue, pull out your sword again, blink once here, move forward a little bit, blink again, go through this door, and then blink towards the back of these people. Pull out your blink again, and blink over over that guy. The timing on the blink is pretty tight. I want to go show that to you again. So make sure that you aim correctly, otherwise you're going to miss the blink, and you'll be very sad. Switch you out here, move forward a little bit, blink again, go through the door, blink toward the back. Check out this blink. See, I'm like this difference. You want to make sure that you blink past him. then double jump over the fence, and then blink to Samuel. If you do this correctly, you should have zero mana at the end of this, which is good. Because at the end of this part of the level right here, you get a refill going into the next one, meaning that it'll give you a full mana bar. So if you're not using your full mana bar before you go into these splits, it's kind of inefficient, or there's just not enough blinks to be used, which is possible as well. But ideally, you want to use all the blinks you can before a refill section.
In Dunwall Tower with the late Empress, so maybe you haven't visited the bridge before tonight. Something to look out.
So I'm gonna try to go through this level once, and then I'll go over it slowly the next time.
You're gonna have to shut off their power before I can pick you up. Now,
maybe I should do it in the other order. I'm not sure.
Maybe even smarter than Piero. Got the whole Dunwall.
I'll do it the other order. So I'll do it slowly the first time, and then I'll show it again.
New technology, potions, and the like seems dangerous to me. But what do I know?
So this first part of the mission, the way it works, is as Samuel's talking, he's gonna give you the mission, but you can get past him before that. So you're gonna jump up here, you're gonna clip through that wall. So you're gonna run through here. And Samuel's still talking. See how the arrow just popped up? That means that he just finished talking. Ideally, this is how you want to do it. You want to get to that door before he finishes talking. That way, you can open the door and have your mana regen before the mission comes up. Do not go through the door until the mission is there. Otherwise, you'll softlock yourself, similar to the other split. So go through here, hit enter, and then this is one of those splits where like it's really laggy when you open it up. So blink once here, blink once there, blink on the ground here, potion, blink here, double jump, and blink onto this beam. Make sure you hold to the left, jump onto here, jump onto the ground right there, and jump up here. Take both of these out. You're going to do a double jump. Aim your cursor right above the flags, double jump, and then at the start of your second jump, blink, double jump here, and grab the door. Once you're through here, you're going to come outside. Double jump, and you want to aim for this. Double jump, and then blink here. You get a damage cancel, and go through the door. Blink here. Potion. Blink onto this roof. Blink onto this roof. And then blink over here. Take out your sleep darts. Hit Sokolov. Pull out your blink. Jump outside. Blink down here. Blink here. And then blink there. I know I did that kind of fast, but this level is actually kind of simple.
Meet you at the arches under Sokolov's place.
So because I'm using the quick save right here, I'm gonna be a little bit slow on this first part of the level.
Got you now.
Which is fine though, because this is just for practice. But I guess I'll show the blinks slowly this time. So blink once here, blink once here, blink here, and then you wanna blink like over this trash can towards the little pylon thing. And once you get through, double jump and blink again. The reason why I got killed is because I just sat there and like looked at it for like 3 seconds, so it charged up its shot.
I'll meet you at the arch.
So you want to do it as fast as possible so it doesn't hit you. If it does hit you, you'll survive the shot, but the important thing is that you don't want it to hit you while you're blinking, otherwise it'll mess up your movement in the air. Blink here, blink here, blink here. Potion blink here, double jump, and then blink up here. So make sure that when you jump here, you don't hold forward, because if you try to double jump into elevated platforms, you'll land most of the time. You'll land into it, and now I can't jump. So I'm still holding spacebar, but I can't double jump because I'm technically already on the ground again. So make sure that you stop your momentum for like a second, go to the left, and then blink here. Jump and blink here. Make sure you hit this little get up option, otherwise you might blink past it. Open this. Take both whale oil tanks out, and then, like I said before, you want to aim right above. You want to aim your cursor right above the flag. So the way that this jump works is when you're mid-air, you want to blink right at the start of your second jump. So you see how it's like the timing is like jump, 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 blink as you're still holding jump. That's what you want to do. So aim right above it, jump, and then blink again, and you should get a damage cancel, ideally. Once you get through this door, the way to set this up, you want to run outside, and then you don't want to wait here for like a really long time, but you want to come out here, and you want to sprint and then jump so that you land on that little tank right there. sprint and jump forward again, and that way you get a damage cancel going into the next part of the level. Jump onto this railing and blink into it. Jump onto this roof. Jump onto this roof. Jump onto this roof. Pull out your sleep darts. You can hit them from whatever range you want to with sleep darts, but it's easier to do it like close range. There's a potion here, and then talk to Samuel, and that's the end of the level.
You made a neat job of it. Drop him here and we'll be off.
So now we are working our way toward the boil split, which is the most RNG heavy part of the run. One of the two parts of the run. This RNG is pretty intensive in terms of like how the outcomes work, how many different outcomes there are, and like why the outcomes are what they are. So I'm not going to explain that in this video. I'm going to link a video in the description. I'll probably put in the description like boil RNG, and then I'll have the link to the video of someone else who's already explained it. I will show you the different placements of the characters for now. So I'll show you like what's good RNG, what's bad RNG. But there's a lot of different outcomes, but I'll show you what I can. So here, hold E again before you take off your mask. And you can dialogue skip right here. And then hit enter, sleep sounds good. And then you go to sleep. So as this mission starts up, you're going to be talking to Emily. She's going to be like, Corvo, wake up. The second that you can talk to her, hit enter for the first option, and then hit your action key immediately. This is going to allow you to not skip the dialogue, but to start it really quickly. So hit enter, hold E, or F, whatever it is. Pull out your blink, blink into the door. Aim your crosshair, the top of your crosshair, right below that windowsill. Blink into it, and then jump and blink into the door. Talk to Sokolov. Hit enter, and then hold E to skip the next part. Open this door. Talk to Pendleton. Pull out your blink. And then talk to Samuel.
Royal costume ball, huh?
The intermission levels are pretty easy, so I don't really have to go over them that much, which is nice. But now we're going to go into the Boyle's mission. So as this mission starts out, you're going to pull your blink out and then double jump over that little wall right here that you see on the right side immediately. And then you're going to want to double jump and blink into on top of a lamp. You want to make sure that you see the arrow indicator that you're going to blink on top of the lamp. Otherwise, it's very hard to miss it because it's so tiny. Also, there's a glitch sometimes where like sometimes the bodies that explode just like fly all the way up in the air. But I haven't seen that too many times recently. Jump here. I come up next to this wall, and it's easy for me to line it up like that. Jump over the fence, jump, and then talk to Shaw immediately to give him the letter that Pendleton just gave you. Double jump here onto the balcony, and then open this door. Similar to how when we got our weapons in the sewer split, how the camera faded from black to the gameplay, we can move. Right here, we can do the same thing. So the second it starts loading, I'm moving to the left, going through this doorway, opening this door, and killing this boil right here. I'm going to blink up top here and grab this note, which is the mission note, and it's going to say Esma Boyle. This means that we have bad RNG. If you pick up the note and it says Samuel's boat, then this is what you're going to do. You grab this potion, you're going to walk out here and open the door. This is if it says go to Samuel's boat. Jump onto the sill, double jump, and then blink here. Ideally, you want to land on top of the thing, but if not, then it's fine. Just blink here, blink here, blink here, and then right there. You're on the boat. Technically, I'm on the boat right now, but Samuel isn't here because we didn't complete the mission. So we're going to do this again. I might have to, like, reload the mission. Okay, no. So this is still bad RNG. So grab the potion, come out here. One boil will be either in this room or across this walkway right here. So jump and kill her. The second boil is either going to be... See how she's right here? Unfortunately... I got stuck and I hit the doorway. Alright, let me try this again so I can show you guys correctly. So the first boil will always be... Oh, I'm just going to reload it. The first boil that we kill when we open the door on the balcony and go to the left, that boil will always be there. And that's the one we always want to kill right at the beginning. Because the way that the RNG is working is if we happen to have her as our target... then that means it's good RNG, we can leave immediately. If it's not, it's unfortunate, you have to kill all the other Boyles.
Good news is, once you get to the party, that mask of yours will let you blend right in. Enjoy your evening out with the folk of quality. Better you than me.
Skin control, jump blink, come up here, jump blink, jump blink, and then jump blink, talk to Shaw, give him the note.
Pendleton is a
jump blink again. Lots of jump blinking in this game. And open the door. Go through right here. Grab here. Grab the note. Bad RNG again. Grab this potion and open the door. So like I said before, the Boyle will either be here or on the back or on the thing right here. And you'll catch the other Boyle either walking here to this doorway. And if she's not there, then she's right here in front of this fireplace, and you kill her. If you kill her at the fireplace, you blink twice to that door. If you kill her here, then you blink through this doorway. Either way, you want to, the exit route, you want to aim towards that same spot that I showed you before. This little part of the fence here. Blink on top of there, blink here, and then talk to Samuel. And that's the end of the level.
I hope you enjoyed your evening, sir.
Like I said before, I will link a video showing the different outcomes of the RNG and how it works. That way it's easier for you to understand it. But I'm not going to go ahead and try to explain that because I'll probably stumble and mumble over myself. So that's the end of the Boyle split. Next, we're going into Tower, which is the last one before Flooded. The reason I say that is because Flooded is like the last real mission until the end of the level. So right here, once we gain control of Corvo, I'm going to blink above those two metal sheets right there, and then I'm going to blink again into Pendleton. I don't know if you can see him right here, but he's actually in that window right there in the opening. I'll just show you in a second. So double jump here, blink, double jump, and then blink into Pendleton. The next thing you're going to do once you stop talking to him is you're going to blink to this door and then open it immediately. The reason that we give the note to Shaw, by the way, is because Pendleton issues a challenge to Shaw or whatever, and by talking to him and then leaving, it like skips a bunch of extra dialogue that Pendleton should have here. Blink here. Swordless. Skip this dialogue. Plant your sword. Blink onto this fence. Blink here, and then blink here. You shouldn't get this hardfall, but I did because I'm bad. I don't want to talk to Pendleton if I can avoid that again. Nice. So blink here, and then blink kind of like above Pendleton, just like in this general area, so you land on this wall. Walk forward, and then blink into Samuel.
Face the Lord Regent. About time we took care of my say. Long past time.
So now we're going into the tower split to kill the Lord Regent, but we're actually going to do the non-lethal version because it's much faster, and we're going to, what's it called, incriminate him by releasing his recorded audio files where that show him, like, being a scumbag, basically. We're going to do an elevator right off the bat here. Those little metal parts at the beginning, you can do elevators across basically all of those, but there's one in particular that's really consistent that we're going to aim for, so I'm going to show you that.
Calls it his safe room or something. Crazy if you ask me. Another point of interest.
This is also, by the way, this is the very beginning of the game, if you didn't recognize it. At the very beginning, we go through here and we climb up, and then the boat is sitting on top of there, and that's where we start the game. But since the beginning, they turned it into like a war fortress, and they like decked it out with like weapons and stuff. So once you gain control of Corvo right here, pull out your blink, you're going to blink up these rocks, and you're going to come right here. See this little flat wall right here? You're going to run here, and then do the elevator into it. And it's going to boost you up onto this fence, double jump here, blink on top, blink here, and we're going to do another double jump blink. I messed it up, so I'm going to redo it. But like I said before, at the start of your second jump, you're going to let go of your blink, and then you're going to blink again before you fall. So there's the elevator, blink here, double jump here, and then blink. Blink over this electric fence and then into the door. Make sure you use your potion in between. Grab this potion, jump onto here, jump onto the chandelier, blink over here, and then into the safe. We're going to clip through it with our by leaning and sprinting into it, and then scroll on your up wheel. That way that when your mouse is over it, it's easy for you to grab it. See how like you can see the hand symbol? That means it's grabbable. So make sure that you scroll on your mouse to grab it like that. Then you're going to jump out here, blink here, use your health potion just in case, because you want to get over this bar and you might get hit by the thing. And then once you're against this wall, you'll see, because you're against this flag, double jump, and then put the audio file into the little thing. And then here we're going to do a slip clip. There's two ways to do this. If you're right oriented, do it like this. I think I die here, actually, if I do it like that. No, I don't. Sick. That was extremely lucky. If I ever get that in a run, I'd be super blessed. But so you do that, and then you flick your mouse. Oh, I did it again. And then to the right, that way you go toward the door. If you're left way oriented, you blink through this way, and you just do the same thing. I'm really bad at left, that's why I messed it up, but I do it like this. I keep getting it, dude. If I get out in a run, that'd be like super lucky for me. But then once you're out here, you blink here, grab this potion, use it, jump here, jump here, jump onto this building, use a potion, and then right as this third pillar thing is in your view, as you're sprinting, you're going to double jump and then blink. And you're going to land onto Samuel and then talk to him, and that's the end of the level.
You ready to go back to the Hound Pits? Thanks to you, Corvo.
So that's the end of Tower. That one's not too difficult. The only hard parts is like sometimes the elevator will be finicky at the beginning, and then sometimes if you're not tight on the blink up onto the stairway, you might get hit by the pylon and you could die to it. So just be careful with that.
Small fry like me always gets the worst of it.
So this is the last intermission level before Flooded. And there is a pretty long cutscene at Flooded, so if any of you figure out ever how to skip it, let me know. I would appreciate that. That would shorten the run by like guaranteed 2 to 3 minutes. Which would be pretty sick. But once you gain control of Corvo here, you're gonna blink onto the stairway in the middle and then blink into the door. I'll show you that in a second. Takes off his mask. Blink here. Blink here. Emily's gonna be here, so make sure you blink past her into the people. Hit E, hit E. Back out. Blink here out the doorway. Double jump onto the railing. Double jump onto this. And then blink into your room. And that's the end of the intermission level. But you still have more stuff to do, so make sure you don't like get up from your seat or anything like that. So as Corvo's getting knocked out, more dialogue scenes are gonna come up. Make sure you skip them.
Samuel, you move like
hold E, and then do it one more time, and we're gonna store the skip all the way through the entirety of this cutscene. If you are, you know, just learning the game and you don't really care about saving like that 1 or 2 seconds that this will save, then by all means, you have enough time to get up, go to the bathroom, get up, get a drink, whatever. If you're pretty quick, you might have time to make a sandwich even. But this cutscene's pretty long, so
this is the one who was with the Empress when she died.
Unless you're like really, really trying to like get really good times, then you don't really have to worry about this that much. But I'm gonna hold E through the entire cutscene for the dialogue skip. I guess during here I should talk about, I just PB'd last night and I finally got my first sub 35, which means I got under 35 minutes for the game for the first time ever. And that boosts me to 11th on the global leaderboards for the game, which is pretty exciting. I never really thought I'd be good at the game, and I, for whatever reason, I've just been improving a lot recently, so I'm pretty excited about that. But if you ever want to watch me stream this live, you can follow me on Twitch at twitch.tv/mmdust, 2 M's and a dust. If you want to follow me on Twitter, you have any questions, stuff like that, you can tweet me at mmdust again. And then if you're watching this video, you're already at my YouTube channel, so yeah. But every time I PB, I'll post a video. I might post more videos on like tutorials and stuff like that, or like tricks or easy things, or like, you know, tips and tricks for like the runs and stuff like that. But Dishonored 2 comes out in like less than a week when I'm recording this. So that's going to be pretty sick. I'm really excited for that, so I hope you guys are too. And I know what it felt like to shovel into your empress.
but I don't know you.
So I'm still holding E through this entire cutscene.
You're a mystery, and I can't allow that.
Throws her weapons away, and we get knocked out. So still holding E. What's gonna happen is we're gonna wake up inside the void. And hold left, and then double jump onto the platform, and it's gonna skip the cutscene. So coming up are probably some of the hardest tricks in the game, or the hardest slip clips and the hardest out of bounds stuff in the game. So I will go a little bit slower on this. First off, we have the Brickless skip. Nicknamed Brickless because I'll show you in a second. So I'm gonna make a quick save, and then I'll show you how the run goes. So right here, when you gain control of the character, how you're supposed to do this is you're supposed to pick these bricks up, you're supposed to throw them at this at these wood stuff, and then break them, and then get your way out, right? But that's really slow. So what you can do is you're gonna slip clip through the side of this like that. Now I know that looked really easy, but it's actually pretty difficult. It's basically we're slip clipping like the way that we usually do, except we have to throw in a jump as well. So the timing is much tighter. And it's very hard to do. So make sure that when you first get this that you don't get too frustrated and you take your time and you really try to practice it and you really try to understand what is working and what isn't working. The way that I line this up is I come right to the wall right here, and the walls are kind of like indented all around. So right when you gain control of your character, if you just hold right, you'll come into the part of the wall that I'm talking about. You want to aim a little bit higher up. You want to lean, walk, and sprint at the same time. And then right as you're like through the furthest part of the wall, you're going to jump. But at the same time, you want to turn your mouse and then blink. The timing is super tight. So if you first run in this game, I would recommend just doing this. Make sure that you throw it and you can like try to bounce the brick. That way it like takes you less shots to do it or less time to do it. But essentially, if you're trying the brickless skip and you don't get it within like 5 seconds, then you're wasting time. Grab those two potions and then jump into the water. You want to make sure, though, that you're careful about when you grab those potions, because there's a sword right there, too, and if you pick up the sword, unlike your regular sword, you can't cheat this one and have your abilities at the same time. So you're going to have the movement speed penalty of the sword the entire way through for the rest of the game. So you want to make sure you don't grab it, because you don't need it for the rest of the run. So right here, you do the brickless skip, grab the two potions, and then jump into the water right here. Right through this crack right here, you're going to blink into the water, and then you're going to blink onto this little archway. Once you get to the middle of the archway, you're going to double jump and blink onto this rooftop. You're going to jump and blink into this room, grab this key and the potion, aim your blink right above the sign, sprint forward, and then land. Once you're here, you're going to use both of your potions and max them out going into the next part. So once again, do that, grab the two potions, jump into the water, blink out, blink onto the archway, jump onto this building. Blink here, grab the potion and the key. Use both potions and then go into here. So this is going to be an out of bounds trick right here. So you're going to slip clip through this wall. You're going to jump right onto this cart and you slip clip right through here. So then you're going to blink here, and then you're going to finally blink into this little sewer grate. The thing that's hard about this though is because it's out of bounds, a lot of the walls and stuff are invisible, so it's kind of hard to see. You'll have to play around with it and really, like, learn it, unless you're just, like, naturally good at it, but I will show you what I mean in a second. Let me make an updated quick save as well. That should be easy. So, quick save. Once you're here, slip clip through here. So, see how I fell out? There is no floor, so you can fall to your death. So you want to be low, but you don't want to be too low. So this is like the perfect height. So you want to blink here. As long as you can see your blinks, you will go to that area. You want to blink here again. The trouble with this is if you don't blink, or if you don't slip clip correctly, and you're too high up, then you can't blink past this. There's an invisible wall, so you want have to go lower, and then you can blink like that. Play around with it. You'll get the hang of it eventually. If you really don't like this skip and want to do the run the regular way, I will show you how to do that. So what you do is you come up here, blink here, blink here, and then blink onto this little part of the broken wall. Double jump, blink here. Grab these two potions. Grab the key, and then run out the window. Jump up here, grab this potion. Jump through this window. Run and slide through here. Jump from the ground. And then go through the grate. And then now we're on the other side of the grate. So that way is much slower, but it's easier to do. So if you want to practice that, you go ahead and do that. Otherwise, you can do the slip clip. Oops. Also, my dogs are crying. So hopefully they let up and allow me to finish this video, because this one take is actually going pretty well, I think. So come through here. Open this door. Don't use a potion yet. You're going to run out here. You're going to double jump and blink onto this metal thingy right here. Double jump, blink here, crouch and grab that potion. Jump on top of that part of the broken train thingy. Jump up here, blink and jump here. Use a potion, grab this mana potion. If you don't grab the health potion, doesn't matter. Jump there, blink here. Double jump and blink onto this railing. Make sure you grab this tank and not slide this thing out, otherwise you'll lose time here. And make sure that when you jump over, you don't, like, try not to jump onto this because you'll take damage. Then blink here, take your potion, and then blink through this door. This is going to be another slip clip. Right as you load out on the other side, you're going to blink past through immediately again. This door is kind of thick. T-H-I-C-C thick. So it's a little bit harder to do. So make sure that when you open the door, you really take your time with this, because it's pretty hard to do. And then once you're outside, you're going to jump over into these rocks and fall into this invisible water stream. Quick save and then quick load. And it's going to... When you load back in, it's going to push you all the way to the end of the current immediately. So then you're going to run over here, double jump here, blink here, and then jump and blink here. Realistically, you shouldn't have this much mana left, but because I've been kind of going slow with the run, I have a little bit extra mana. So once you're here, double jump, blink here, jump here, make sure you hit this, otherwise you'll fall underneath of it and it'll mess you up, and then blink through the door. And that's the end of Flooded. So now we're starting the second last mission of the game, the Loyalist Split. I'm gonna run out here, jump up here. Usually I have one blink left, so I'll play like I have one blink left. Grab that potion, grab those two keys, blink once here, and then I'll use my potion. Open this door, grab this note, and then blink past these guards. Once you're here, double jump here, grab this railing, jump up here, and then slip clip through this door. I messed up. Messed up again. Turn this, and then grab these two potions. Jump off the ledge here, and then jump into the water. What you want to do here is, usually I have one blink as well, so you're going to blink here, and then you're going to wait here and hold spacebar near the boat. This is going to trigger Samuel's dialogue early on, and allow you to skip half of it by blinking back into him, and then skipping immediately again. One more trip across. While this goes, I'm going to let my dog out real quick. I'm sorry, guys. That's where the Lord Regent was building his new lighthouse. Ought to be something to see. So once you finish the Loyalists, make sure you hit enter to skip that scene again. That way you lose as little time as possible. And then this is the last level of the game. There's two sections of it, but this is the last mission. And it's fairly simple, so this won't take very long to go over. So once you gain control of Corvo, there's a mana potion right here along the bank. It's right there. You can see it from here. You want to grab that immediately, and then you're going to start the run. Or this level.
Good luck, Corvo. If anyone deserves it, you do.
Pull out your blink immediately. Grab the potion. Blink here. And then you're going to blink onto this little tiny thing right here. And you're going to get the auto get up. Then you're going to double jump again. Oops. Let me try that again, because I'm going slow. I don't know why my autosaves are so messed up, man.
Best Emily.
Quick save. That'll make it easier. Blink here. Blink here. Double jump here. And then double jump again. And then... I don't know why it's messing up my spacing. Alright, let's try this again. Here. 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 double jump here, and then you want to blink into this little thing right here for the auto get up, and you want to grab the potion as you do it. That's the quickest way that you can go about it. Otherwise, you can just turn around and grab the potion, but it is faster to do it that way. I missed it, but that's what you want to do. Then double jump here, you're out of mana, use a potion, double jump there, and then here you're going to aim your crosshair right above this little white bar thing right here. You see the bottom of my crosshair? You're going to aim it there, and then once you get to the aim of, to the end of this platform, you're going to do the double jump blink again. Like that. And you blink here. Should get past them, but because I'm going slow, they're positioned weird. Like this. Oh wait, no, I lied to you, by the way. You want the top of your crosshair to be below the bar, not the other way around. I'm sorry. This. Like this. That way you get the damage cancel. That's why you didn't get it the first time. Once you're on the stairs, slow down. That way you don't jump into the stairs again. And then you go through this, and you hit the switch, and hit enter. So that's the first half of this level. Now we're going to go in the last part. I'm going to do it one more time. Try to go as smoothly as possible. That way you guys can see what it looks like without messing up. Like that. That's how it should look for the most part. You can slip, you can throw in one more blink like onto the stairway if you want to, but just be careful with it. So this is the very last part. This part should only take you, if you're quick about it, between 10 to 12 seconds. But if you mess up, it'll take you longer. As soon as you gain control, you want to go outside the right door. So take your camera and look all the way to the right, and pull out your blink. Blink onto the top of the staircase, jump out, blink over here, and then blink next to this guard so that he backs up to the left. Blink past here, jump and blink here, blink towards here, grab this key, and then open the door. The second that you open the door, the game is over. If you do not grab your key, you're gonna have to go back and get it, and you'll lose a lot of time for that. So that's the run. Make sure that if you're recording this and you want to upload your times, that you continue recording through this. It makes it easier just for them to confirm that you did it, and like it's not like a corrupted game file or something like that. I don't know. You will stand up. But this is how it goes. Guiding her young mind and protecting her from those who seek. And yeah, that's the run, guys. So I feel like I may have gone through that too quickly. I don't know. Let me know, guys, what you think. If I wasn't clear on certain things or you want me to go back over things, I can make different videos. But for the most part, I think I did fairly okay on explaining this route. That is the any percent yes route currently for Dishonored 1. I just real quickly, if you want to see my mappings or my things, the biggest one I have changed for my shortcuts is like these. So just quickly look at those. I have them set up because the way that the game works is however order they assign your weapons in the order that you receive them. So for example, if I don't buy the grenade where I buy them and I get them later on, they might be on a different shortcut, right? So I have it set up to where my one is for my regular crossbow, like the one that does damage. My 2 is set up to be, I'm sorry. The shortcuts, these are the slots, these are the keys I press. So when I press 1, I pull out the damaging crossbow. When I press 2, I pull out my sleep darts. When I press 3, I bring out my blink. And when I press 4, I bring out my grenade. So in the order that you receive them in the run, the 1 is the regular crossbow. The sleeping dart, I don't know how to explain this, whatever, I'm going to leave this part out of the video. GG, you guys. I don't know, GG, you guys. Good video.